This is the story, Listen, How Evelyn Glennie, a Deaf Girl, Changed Percussion. This is a story of music, of obstacles, of strength and hard work, of all you can accomplish when you dream. If you find your own way to, listen. If your ears can't hear the strum or hum or thrum of a melody, can music still swirl and whirl? It did for Evelyn Glennie. Listen. In the late 1960s, Scottish music rolled through the farm hills of Aberdeenshire, Scotland, where Evelyn Glennie grew up. Her heart swelled when air blew from the bellows of her father's accordion on Christmas Eve. On Sunday, she sat on the organ bench next to her mother. A curtain closed behind them, creating their own tiny world of pipes and pedals. From the moment Evelyn heard her first note, music held her heart. Evelyn played piano songs by ear at 8 years old. Tink, tink, tink. Clarinet notes slid through her lips when she was 10. Woo, woo, da, woo. But soon, her ears began to hurt. Voices became distant whispers. Evelyn's parents took her to the audiologist. He frowned. The nerves in Evelyn's ears are degenerating. She's never going to be able to play music. She's going to need hearing aids for the rest of her life, and she's going to need to go to school for the deaf. Evelyn didn't understand. Only 30 minutes earlier, she'd been able to play music, and now she couldn't? Why? She wanted to wear hearing aids, read lips, and play music. She wanted to choose which school she went to. Evelyn's parents shook their heads at the doctor. No, her father told him. Hearing or not, she will do what she wants to do. After completing primary school at 11 years old, Evelyn decided to continue her traditional education at Ellen Academy, a secondary school. By this time, a ringing phone sounded like muffled crunches in her ears. Still, the percussionist in the orchestra caught her attention. Rat-a-lat-a-lat-a-lat, danced the snare drum sticks. Dum-deedle-a-dum-dum, bounced the marimba mallets. Bum-wum-bum, thumped the timpani sticks. Evelyn knew immediately, I want to be a part of that. Every first-year student was tested for musical ability. Questions kindly crackled through a tape recorder. Evelyn strained to hear. She scored poorly. They tested only her ears' ability to listen, not her heart's and not her body's. For the next few months, Evelyn begged the school for percussion lessons. Finally, a percussion teacher named Ron Forbes tested her ability to read music and play rhythms. Thanks to years of piano lessons, she passed. For her first lesson, Mr. Forbes gave Evelyn a strange assignment. He sent her home with a snare drum. No instructions, no sticks, no stand, just a drum. So Evelyn tapped it, she pinched it, she scraped it with her fingernails, and she turned it upside down. She rubbed her jewelry on it. Every action created a different vibration. At her second lesson, Mr. Forbes asked, "How did you get on?" "I don't know," she admitted. He knew she lived on a farm. "How does a tractor feel?" he asked. Evelyn closed her eyes. She felt the light, tingly squeak of an old, creaky tractor. She rolled onto the tips of her toes, and she played an old, creaky tractor. Tick-a-tick-tick, tick-a-tick-tick, tick-a-tick-tick. Then Evelyn felt the raucous roar of a brand-new engine. She dug her heels into the floor, and she played the roar of a brand-new engine. Vroom! Evelyn, do you think you could hear more if you took your hearing aids out? Evelyn looked at Mr. Forbes as if he had three heads, but she took them out. Mr. Forbes and Evelyn placed their hands on the wall of the classroom. She watched his lips for direction. Listen. He struck the timpani, a big drum that creates big vibrations. Whum! Then he asked a question that changed her life forever. Evelyn, can you feel the sound in your body? He struck the drum again. Evelyn's whole body resonated, her belly, her back, her legs, her feet. She kicked off her shoes. Her heart raced. Whum! Vibrations moved through her fingertips, her hand, her arm, then crossed her chest and tickled her other arm. Her heart answered, whum, whum. She had found a sea of sound that belonged only to her. In that moment, every other sense intensified, as if Evelyn's whole body had become one giant ear. She listened to the buzz of the wide world around her. Vroom! Distant trucks zoomed by. Evelyn's legs listened, hum, hum, humming with the rattle of the road. Wah, wah, wah! Muffled voices muddled through an underwater fog. Evelyn's eyes listened, turning murmurs into words. Thrum, hum, hum! Evelyn became so sensitive to each vibration that she could tune an instrument based only on where she felt the vibrations in her body. When she graduated at the age of 16, Evelyn auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music in London. But they turned her down. No one believed a deaf musician could have a career in music. But Evelyn believed. If she could learn to think about listening in a whole new way, then they could too. Evelyn knew that sound and touch weren't that different. Air vibrated, traveling through the judge's ears before turning into sound. For Evelyn, those vibrations traveled through her body. Her brain just listened differently. Evelyn fought for the right to audition again. "Does my ability meet the standards of the school?" she asked. They agreed that it did. One board member argued that she deserved a second audition. The board agreed. Again, Evelyn kicked off her shoes. She looked directly into the judge's wide eyes as she played. Rattle-a-da-let, her snare drum sticks danced. Dum-diddle-um-dum-dum, her marimba mallets bounced. Bum-wum-bum, her timpani sticks thrummed. Everything resonated together. The sticks, the mallets, the keys, the room. And Evelyn. This time, they didn't just hear her. They listened. Her music flowed through their ears and their bodies and into their hearts. They welcomed her into the academy. After that, every music school in Great Britain changed its rules. Everyone agreed no one should be turned away simply because of a disability. During her second year at the Royal Academy of Music, Evelyn entered a national percussion competition. She took chances interpreting the music her way, and she won. Her heart fluttered when she received the prestigious Queen's Commendation for both music and academic excellence. And at the age of 17, she again kicked off her shoes to perform the very first solo percussion concerto at the Royal Academy of Music. As she sank into the cushion of broad sounds, the audience sank too. As she jabbed at short, sharp sounds, the audience jabbed too. Evelyn played with a freedom that no one had ever heard before. Europe listened. Soon, television shows documented Evelyn's life. After graduating, she was invited to perform Bartok's Sonata for two pianos and percussion. The piece was recorded by CBS Records and gave Evelyn the first of two Grammy Awards. She recorded albums and performed in more than 40 countries. And the Queen of England knighted her, Dame Evelyn. The world listened. Evelyn remembered the audiologist who thought people could only hear with their ears. He was wrong. Losing my hearing, she said, made me a better listener. Evelyn Glennie became the first full-time solo percussionist in the world. She owns nearly 3,000 instruments, all of which sing in her hands. Throughout her life, many people told her, "No, you can't." But Evelyn always knew she could. And you can too, if you only... Shh. Listen.